What makes arowana fish so expensive? The value of certain arowana fish can reach tens of thousands of dollars due to their rarity and high demand in the aquarium and pet trade. Despite its unassuming appearance, the endangered arowana fish holds such a high value that individuals have faced imprisonment due to their involvement in its illicit trade and poaching. The arowana fish gets its name for how it resembles a dragon in flight as it swims. The arowana fish is like a dragon in motion while swimming, capturing the majestic appearance of a flying dragon in the water. In other countries, they call it dragonfish, but in Asian countries, they call it Asian arowana. Originating from Southeast Asia, the freshwater arowana fish has gained significant popularity and made a remarkable impact on the global aquarium market. Nowadays, these highly valued fish have gained such admiration that they even have motorcades dedicated to them. Other breeders ensure their protection by constructing barriers with concrete walls around their stock. Intriguingly, there is a market for cosmetic enhancement in arowana fish where procedures like eye lift or chin tucks are performed on those with less desirable features in an effort to improve their appearance. Although this might be excessive, it is actually quite reasonable for the beauty of arowana fish. The high value placed on arowana fish has unfortunately led to a significant increase in criminal activities associated with their trade. Recent accounts have revealed incidents of homicides and nocturnal fish thefts, all linked to the pursuit of arowana fish. Before the 20th century, arowana fish were not prominently displayed or considered as a status symbol. Before this period, these fish were primarily consumed by locals as a part of their regular diet. In 1967, an aquarium trader captivated by the striking appearance of an arowana he encountered at a Malaysian food market. Then he decided to acquire one for personal enjoyment as a pet. Within a few decades, following the initial interest in arowanas in 1960s, this unique fish gained widespread popularity across Asia, sparking a desire among people from various regions to own one. The red and gold arowana species became symbol of prosperity and good fortune in numerous Asian cultures, further fueling their appeal and desirability. This has resulted in the creation of an entire fish mythology. It even has the ability to leap out of its tank to save its owner, which is said to bring luck and prosperity. Today, breeding for new color combination of arowana is very popular these days. One of the most expensive arowana is the Chile Red, which has the price of 80,000 pesos or $1,500 each. The other expensive color of arowana is the Super Red, which has a huge price of $12,000 or 648,000 pesos. But no fish is more rare and valuable than the albino arowana. The albino arowana is the most valuable and uncommon fish. In 2009, one of these supposedly set a record, selling for $300,000 or 6,200,000 pesos. The majority of arowana fish buyers are actually middle-class Chinesemen who collect the fish as a status symbol. A significant proportion of arowana fish buyers are middle-class Chinesemen who often acquire this fish as a means of displaying their social standing and prestige. Thus, raising this fish is a highly masculine pastime. Only few women would be interested in keeping it as a pet. For hobbies, owning an arowana is similar to collecting automobiles or highly pricey items. Arowana fish were becoming rare in the wild as a result of overfishing. Therefore, it was a very important milestone when they were successfully raised in captivity on certified farms in the mid-1990s. Since then, more demand has led to breeding operations all over Southeast Asia. Because of this demand, have resulted in breeding activities throughout Southeast Asia. Although purchasing an arowana fish is lawful in the Asian region, it might not be in other Asian nations. In the United States, one can primarily encounter the Asian arowana fish only on the black market. It is important to note that importing the arowana fish into the United States is not legally permissible because it's banned by the U.S. Endangered Species Act. The reason behind the restriction is that the Asian arowana fish is prohibited under the U.S. Endangered Species Act. People have actually gone to prison for trafficking the arowana fish. Some individuals have faced imprisonment as a consequence of trafficking the Asian arowana fish, which is a violation of the law. If you are in US and you have a desire to own a pet fish similar to Asian arowana, it will be advisable to explore legally available aquatic species to ensure compliance with the law. But if you are in Asian country that allows buying of arowana fish, you may consider on buying this fish. This might be the one that will bring us good luck. If you want to buy an arowana, it is more advisable for me to order a small one first so that you can learn how to properly care for them. The large arowana needs a large space because they can hit the glass with their head when they are stressed, which can cause their death. I used to take care of a silver arowana, but because it was so big, it jumped into the aquarium. So if you are just starting to take care of it, you should buy the one which is small one first. Also, the small one is cheaper compared to the bigger arowana. This size is worth 150,000 to 200,000 pesos. If you are here in the Philippines and want to know where I saw these arowanas, this is the answer. You can see this arowana in Cartimar, located in Pasay City near the Mall of Asia. There are many different arowanas there and I just didn't take a video because the weather was too hot during that time. The best arowana I have seen is the red arowana butterfly, but I have not seen it in this place. It looks like a full red arowana, then its fins are very long like a betta fish. Could you imagine how beautiful that arowana is? I only saw it in the post on social media, but I don't remember the name of the pet shop. That's all everyone. I would like to say thank you for all of those who added a comment in my video. Thank you very much, MacDaily012, Gopi Wazun, The Bash 3152, and Michael Monte Lano 6228. See you on my next video. This is Chuck, and you're watching Biker Drone.